Hi guys, DJ here. I think I am recording episode number 10. It's nearly the end of the day now. I wasn't in the mood vlogging earlier because we just had a death in the family. A very close uncle of mine passed away in the Philippines, and it was a very quick and very sudden death. And it makes you realize how short and quick, and it makes you realize how short time we have here on earth. I didn't do much today. I did a lot of landscaping though, because I felt like I want to do some construction done. Funny thing is that my uncle was actually great in construction. So as I was mourning this whole time, I was, you know, thinking of him, you know, like what would have been the experience if he's with me here doing the construction together and doing all this project together. So this morning I did landscaping. I actually extended our driveway, so now you can park 3 cars in the driveway, well, plus the trailer, so it looks pretty nice. So I did the driveway, but it's not done yet. I still have to put the gravel on, but that's just a DIY thing. So yeah, the whole time I was, you know, contemplating and how fragile our lives are. Even though we're in the middle of pandemic, people of the COVID-19 thing, and a lot of people are dying from it. There are also sickness, like I would say regular sickness out there that you could die from, right? And the thing is that if it's your time, it's your time. But at the same time, if you didn't do all the things that you can in the very short period of time you have on earth, I think that's my greatest, in my opinion, I think that's the greatest, most heaviest regret that I have, is when I didn't finish the things that I wanted finished, when I didn't finish my project, when I didn't even give a chance to the ideas and the opportunities I have in life. It's kind of suck, you know? I can't remember the author, but some very well-known author said that I think it was W. Clement Stone actually, that if you want to see a field of talents, if you want to see where the real treasure is in this world, where wisdom and potential and innovation, all of these things, you can actually find them in cemeteries, because that's where they were buried. Many of us has so much potential in us, and that we tend to underestimate the gifts given to us. My uncle that just passed away, he was a great carpenter. He was a great contractor. He was doing construction ever since I knew him. He was a great basketball player. Like, he was one of those MVP stars when he was younger, and that he was actually drafted to play nationally back in the Philippines. Tall guy, I think he was that time 6'1 or 6'2. Good looking back then, and lots of charisma. And, you know, he has so much potential in him that when I was back in the Philippines, I wanted to start a project, a business with him. And I told him, listen, like, if this thing falls through, I think this is gonna be the, you know, the ultimate business model that we're gonna be launching here in the Philippines. Something to do about transportation and how I received a great service when I was there, and I was gonna copy the same business model. And it was great until the pandemic arrived. All of that went to scratch because we couldn't do anything. Like, I can't even go there right now. But again, like what I said on my message to him in my Facebook profile, I told him that, you know, we had so much plans, but God's plans are better than ours. And I truly believe that. And now that he's gone, and now that he's with our Creator now, I think that is the ultimate plan for all of us. Eventually, we are going to die, and eventually we're going to go back to him. And one thing that I want to tell him when I see him, when I see our God, is that I gave it my all, and that I gave everything I can in his name, and that I took care of the blessings that he gave me, and I grew, you know, the opportunities, the seeds that he blessed me. I think that's what I'm gonna tell him when I meet him face to face. But at the end of the day, guys, like, you know, I'm glad that I'm doing this vlogging now. I'm glad that I'm connecting to the world, not because it's fun, but because of times like this, like I can actually connect to the world on the things that I think a lot, that I ponder. And this is one of those things, you know, like my son and I are just raking our way out from this landscaping project that I started. And it was a good feeling too, you know, having to work side by side with my six-year-old son. And those are the things that I'm really grateful for, you know, staying alive, having that opportunity, one more day, one more hour, one more minute to spend here on earth. So I just want to leave you guys with that. Yeah, so we are mourning now, and that I ask you guys to pray for us, pray for strength for the family left behind, especially my cousins and my aunts and my grandpa that's still has to do to deal with the wake and whatnot. So all right, I'm not even gonna ask you to subscribe on this channel anymore, because you know this is a video tribute to my uncle that passed away, and we're gonna miss you.